on WPRI 1500 in Indianapolis.
The Martin Bender Band Share Show.
Martin, you will not believe what I heard after we left the studio yesterday. You would not believe it.
I'll believe it.
I kid you not.
I'll believe it. I'm a believer.
I leave the studio and I listen to a radio preacher talk about how the difference between man and animal is that man has an immortal soul. I kid you not. After we've just been telling people.
You're kidding me.
Now,
that's ridiculous.
We were talking yesterday. We've been talking about what is the difference between the scriptures and the religions, four major religions. And one of the things we pointed out is that the scriptures acknowledge the literalness and the fact that man is dead.
Yeah. Ugly truth, but.
Ugly truth.
But highlights life. Highlights life.
Whereas all other scriptures say that there really is no death.
Right.
It's life in another place. And this is, and these teachers, these Christian teachers, finding themselves in absolute agreement with Muslims.
And Satan,
that man doesn't really die. That man has an immortal soul. And I was taught this from
you. So where did the animals come into this?
This
program did what? They talked about animals?
Yeah, they say that animals and man, the only difference between man and animal is that man has an immortal soul, which is a strange doctrine. You know, the first time the word soul is used in Genesis 1:20, and it's regarding animals. Animals have souls, too.
Yeah.
They're living,
the living souls. That's what the Bible says.
So man's degenerate theology once again comes through in denying the scriptures. And so we got to be careful. I want to read you a passage. And we talk about this, that man is not immortal. 1 Timothy 6:16. I want to read this, and I'm going to ask those who are listening to actually believe what's being read. Believe this, okay? I know it's a stretch, but we're reading here in 1 Timothy chapter 6. He is King of kings and Lord of lords, who alone has immortality. Speaking of the living God.
Doesn't Paul know that David and Moses and all those great men of God, Adam, that they had died? Where were they at this time?
They were dead. Dead. And Paul is dead today, stone cold dead. Only God has immortality.
Christ.
And God gave Christ to have life in himself, that he may give life. He is the resurrection of life. But yet man keeps perpetuating. We keep going back to Genesis 3. Satan said, to die you shall not be dying.
We need to keep going back there.
And Genesis 3 is the source of this wicked teaching. And this satanic teaching is really a self-exaltation of man. The whole teaching of immortality of the soul is the exaltation of man. And this is what's going to happen in the coming great tribulation that's coming on this earth. This worship of this, it's a self-exalting worship.
Do you remember I was telling you that...
it's the lie.
Yeah, you remember up until the time there's no more death at all when God abolishes death?
Yeah, right.
We can distinguish between those who have death and those who don't. I mean, those who are dead and those who are alive. As you just pointed out, this gives some people an advantage, because obviously if there's immortal life and if there's the immortality of the soul, then you either go on to a good place or a bad place. And so once again, that causes the human to have to work for those places. Where am I? Even in the Catholic religion, we had to work to get out of purgatory. We had to pray people out of purgatory. If you're going to make that distinction that some are alive but they're in a good place, others are alive but they're in a bad place, then you just bring into that whole scenario human works, human accomplishments, a distinction between those who are good and those who are bad, and it encourages that and incites it.
Can we look at a couple passages? Let's go to the scriptures on this. 1 Corinthians 15. Verse 42. Start there. I'd like to go through some of these if you don't mind. For those of you listening, this might be a little tedious, but we're going to go through line by line a couple verses here because it's important that we get the right information, because Satan is active in this sphere. He cannot stand this teaching we're about to talk to you about. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 42, thus also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption. It's referring to our bodies. Our bodies are sown in corruption. It is roused in incorruption. It is sown in dishonor. It is roused in glory. It is sown in infirmity. It is roused in power. It is sown a soulish body. It is roused a spiritual body. If there is a soulish body, there is a spiritual also. Thus it is written also, the first man, Adam, became a living soul. Did you hear that? Adam was a living soul. The last Adam, a vivifying spirit. But not first the spiritual, but the soulish, thereupon the spiritual. But notice this, it says about Adam, he wasn't spiritual. He was soulish. Do you ever hear people say that Adam died a spiritual death in the Garden of Eden?
Oh, yeah, because...
How can Adam die a spiritual death if he wasn't spiritual?
Yeah, there's no... The spirit and death are antithetical
exactly.
concepts.
So the first man was out of the earth, soilish. The second man is the Lord out of heaven. Such as the soilish one is, such are those also who are soilish. And such as the celestial one, such are those also who are celestials. And according as we wear the image of the soilish, we do that right now, we should be wearing the image of the also of the celestial, referring to Christ. Now here is the key. Now this I am averring, brethren, that flesh and blood is not able to enjoy the allotment of the kingdom of God, neither is corruption enjoying the allotment of incorruption. Lo, a secret I am telling you. We all indeed shall not be put to repose, yet we shall all be changed in an instant, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For he will be trumpeting, and the dead will be roused incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible, referring to our corruptible bodies, must put on incorruption, and this mortal put on immortality. I want to stop there.